wished everybody could sit and stand right here and look out over this crowd. It does a chairman's heart good to look out there and see the heart and soul of this Republican Party. It's not about us. It's not about the RPI headquarters. It's not even about the State Central Committee. It's about you. And you are the heart and soul of this particular party. And our faith, our freedom, and our family, those are the values that we are going to take to 2014 elections. And those are the values that are going to be taken under that golden dome in Des Moines and under that dome in Washington, D.C. And there's going to be a change. I can hear it just like I can hear the ocean in a seashell. And you folks are going to be the bearers of that great news. So thank you on behalf of the Republican Party of Iowa. Senator Grassley, back in Cedar County, there's one thing I could say to you that would be the highest compliment that I could give. Chuck Grassley is not just a farmer. Chuck Grassley is a farmer, and that means he reflects Iowa values, that means he reflects Republican values, and that means he is exactly the senator that we want to care for us. He is just a farmer, and good for him, we're proud of you. You know, when that comment was made, I think it's more important than just the fact that we got a little insight into what Bruce Braley really felt, where Bruce Braley's heart really was. I don't think that was a gaffe that Bruce Braley made. I really don't. I think we got one of those instances, sometimes a rare instance, when you're looking at a federal election, when you can actually see, you can actually feel exactly what a politician is thinking. Because after all, when we send our folks to Des Moines, when we send our people to Washington, D.C., we are actually sending them there with our trust. With our trust that they're going to use the heart that's set out in our Republican Party platform, the heart that is set out when you folks started this whole process back in your individual counties and your individual precincts. We know now what Bruce Braley's heart said. Bruce Braley, to mean the very heart and soul of what Iowa values and our foundational values are made of. We know that. We also know about Joni Ernst. We know about the heart of a soldier. We know about the heart of a mother and a parent. We know about the heart of a state senator. Joni Ernst is never going to forget home. And when I say she's never going to forget home, she's not going to forget her faith, she's not going to forget her family, she's not going to forget her freedom. Folks, when Joni Ernst casts a vote, she's going to be looking straight back to Iowa. Bruce Braley has forgotten who he was before he even left. Folks, let's nip this thing in the bud before it goes too far. And I can't do it, Steve Scheffler can't do it, even Joni Ernst can't do it. Folks, you are the heart and soul of this party. Only you can do that. Only you can ensure that the people that we are sending to Washington, D.C. are going to reflect exactly who we are. Because every decision that's made is a decision that's made from the heart. That heart gains control of the head, but it's the heart first. And that's the decisions that we're making. That's why I want my D.C. folks to have the heart of a farmer. That's why I want our D.C. folks and our Des Moines folks to have the heart of a family person. And that's why I want to make sure that our folks that go there believe in the sanctity and the love and the strength of family. And that's exactly what Joni Ernst represents and what David Young represents and what all of our great candidates represent, because they represent you. And you ultimately are the ones at those precinct levels that told us exactly what you wanted us to reflect. And I just want to say this. I agree. I got so much to say. I'm talking really fast. I don't even care about applause. I just got to get this off my chest, because I'm fired up today. Because 2014 is going to be our year. That's why I'm fired up today. And we do have a dream team for our candidates. But it's not a dream where the media or the Democrats would like to paint, a dream that's embedded in a about this party. It's not necessarily about me. It's not necessarily about you right now. It's about my grandchildren that I haven't had the privilege of meeting yet. But we're doing this now for the future. Republicans look ahead. Republicans look towards the future, and Republicans see a sunset at the end of every, or a sunlight at the end of every sunset. And I just want to end with this anecdote. And it's something that occurred to me and that I was a part of the last year I served in the legislature. And I think it brings all of this together about the quality of the leaders that we send and what the Republican Party stands for. There was a bill that was assigned to me in the Judiciary Committee. And I was assigned a whole lot of bills in the Judiciary Committee. And I didn't get a chance to read this particular bill right away. And eventually a mom came and talked to me and asked me why her bill hadn't had a committee hearing. I said, let me read it. She came back the next day. It was a very simple bill. The bill essentially issued a birth certificate from the state for a stillbirth. Now, for a lot of people, that wasn't a huge issue. A lot of people haven't had to go through the tragedy of a stillbirth. For this young lady that came and visited me, this was everything to her. Because without that certificate to her, her baby was not alive. And that's all that she wanted. And I asked her when we ran the bill, and we were able to get a great deal of support from the House and the Senate. And I asked her to come out and sit by me when we passed that on the House. And when those votes went up, that young lady who was sitting right beside me in the clerk's chair, with tears rolling down her cheeks, said one thing to me. She says, you listen. Democracy worked. All we want our leaders to do is reflect what you all are a part of. And that's faith, that's family, that's democracy. And that's the reason our dream team is going to win, because we don't have to apologize as Republicans what we believe and what we stand for. And come 2014, folks, it's going to be morning again in this country. Thank you.